There are 40 parts in John Sessions' one-man piece about Napoleon, and he plays them all. It's not because he's on an ego trip, it's not just because it's cheap. It does, though, give him a chance to use many of his spitting image voices, even when they don't seem particularly relevant.
He was everything Napoleon wasn't. A modest, a self-effacing, with a regular...
Yes, that's Laurence Olivier as the narrator.
Chin up, mate. You look just like Shell after she stood me up.
And that's Lofty from EastEnders.
Yes. And remember, you've got a brother who loves you.
But why are they in a play about Napoleon?
I mean, Larry is the narrator. I mean, he has to sweep. I use that in a football sense, all the information that's not provided by Napoleon and all the other characters. And, of course, Napoleon is a very forthright character, and Tom Watts, who I characterise as his brother,
Giuseppe, is very sort of worried and very much like the part that Lofty plays in EastEnders.
One of the reasons, I think, really why I did use all the voices was, first of all, so I could populate the stage with a recognisable cast. And then secondly, I thought, well, if you're going to use these people, why not, let's say, in the case of, say, Paul Daniels or Sean Connery or Richard Briers or Peter O'Toole, actually introduce their personalities into the story.
Why Napoleon?
It's a history of life, I suppose, but at the same time, you get the story of the little man. The little man.
Happily, Napoleon and Josephine are also in the play.
The terrible Josephine. Complete disaster. Come on, darling, chin up.
And Napoleon opens on Monday at the Riverside Studio in Hammersmith for a 5-week run. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.
And just crinkle your nose up and flash your eyes.
Oh, I couldn't do that, Josephine. I'd look like Marty Feldman.